Thank you. Welcome to St. Michael's. Please stand.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Mike died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Mike, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as the sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'll get there. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know the one who raised Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light of affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate them one from the other, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill, and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry, or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked or ill or in prison, and not minister to your needs. You will answer them, "Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for the least, for one of the least, these least ones, you did not do for me." And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I just want to begin by one more time just offering my condolences to Mike's immediate family, to Kyle and Lindsay and Katie, and especially Deb and all of his siblings. And you know, there's so many people in here who were so close to Mike and had the opportunity to really receive and give love to him throughout his life. I'm very sorry for your loss. When someone who is very important to us passes away, as human beings, we have a multitude of emotions and different reactions to the person's passing away. Of course, initially, there's a bit of a shock, and there's always a void and kind of an emptiness that comes with the loss of that person. The most common thing is we feel tremendously sad, and we feel sometimes angry. We wonder how God could allow someone so special to us to pass away and leave this earth. Another thing that we also do, or one of the reactions that we have when someone passes away, is we start to talk about why that person was special to us. And a lot of times, as with the Condon family, large families get together and are able to share stories about this person and why they meant so much to us. And there's, of course, a gratitude and a pain at the same time as we share those stories and we share why that person was so important to us. And so one thing that a lot of times we forget is how very close God is to us in an indirect manner. God is very, very close to us all the time. And sometimes God reveals himself to us through other people. All goodness, all beauty, all truth comes from God. In so much as we experience beauty, truth, and goodness, we ourselves are experiencing a revelation, an indirect revelation of God himself to us. Mike himself was given very many gifts from God, and he revealed the goodness of God in his person in many ways and gave a taste of the goodness of God in his own person. One of the most obvious ways that Mike manifested God was in his own self-offering. One of the obvious ways of how much he constantly gave to his family, how much on a daily basis he loved Deb and the kids. And with almost 34 years of marriage, gave himself to his wife as Christ gave himself to the church for 33 years of his time on earth. He loved the kids in a very humble way. And he loved them through his actions and the constant activities that he would do with the kids and Deb as well. From playing pretty princess with the girls to, as the kids started to get older, and the various sports that they played, going to every single game possible, even in college, and making that effort of just being there and pouring himself out for his family. Even as his health failed, Mike tried to give what energy he could for his family. Because just like we heard about in the gospel, God gives us certain people to take care of. God is very imperceptible very often, but he is there, as the parable told us. And so Mike was given this beautiful family, and he, even as his health was diminishing, he gave what little energy he had in service to his family. I think about Jesus on the cross and the words that he spoke as he was at his very last moments, offering his own mother to the church, offering his forgiveness to those who were persecuting him. Mike manifested the presence of God as a friend and a sibling and an example. He was the type of person who wanted to give himself not for himself in social gatherings, but he went always trying to make sure that everybody was comfortable and maybe talking with the person that was not in another conversation, maybe on the outskirts of the party. He was very talented. God gave him many gifts physically. He was very humble in his talents. And he didn't like talking about himself. He wanted to bring attention to everybody else that he was with. We, as we are in our sadness and our mourning over the death of a good man, as the first reading from Wisdom talked about a just man, we just offer him to God with our prayers. We ask God to take him to himself. We pray that Mike may be with all the angels and saints and may continue to be with us in a different way, in a more imperceptible way, but in a real way. And Jesus, we ask you to take your brother Michael to yourself. We ask you to console his family who is still here, that they may have hope in the resurrection, and that they may feel the peace of being a child of God with the hope and the expectation that they will join with their father and husband and brother and friend. We ask all these things through your holy name, Lord Jesus, amen. Now let's just take a few moments in silent prayer to just pray to the Lord for the soul of our brother, Mike, and to just listen to the Holy Spirit. confident that God our Father takes care of our needs and draws all things to himself, we bring our prayers and our petitions before him.
In baptism, Mike received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Mike was nourished at the table of our Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and await the kingdom, especially Mike's parents, Patrick and Norma. Grant them an everlasting home with your son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear me.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Mike who seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Mike. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, please receive your son, Michael, and receive all the prayers that we brought before you. We ask you to grant them all through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Michael, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For as one alone he accepted death so that we all might escape from dying, as one man he chose to die so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choir of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim, Holy,
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 Holy
Lord,
Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Those who are able, please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember your servant Mike, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
For Holy Communion, because of our COVID restrictions, we, two Eucharistic ministers, myself and another person, will come around and we will spray the hands of all of those receiving Holy Communion. Someone will head, and we'll then give Holy Communion to those here present. I want to particularly welcome all of our non-Catholic brothers and sisters here. You are always welcome in the Catholic Church. I would ask, though, that only those Catholics, those practicing Catholics, receive Holy Communion. Anyone else, when we come by with the Eucharist, if you would please cross your arms. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Walk by your side. I can
can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand to my knees? Will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Michael may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated for the words of remembrance.
Morning. First of all, Deb, Kyle, Alexis, Lindsay, Katie, we'd all like to offer our sincere condolences. We will always be here for you, and we love you just like we loved your dad. Brian, Peggy, Jane, Karen, Kay, John, Kathy, we also offer our sincere condolences to you for the loss of a great brother and a great friend. To begin with this morning, I'd like to ask for a little audience participation. So in a minute, I'm going to ask you to take a deep breath. But when you take that deep breath and let it out, I want you to look around at the family and friends that are close to you. Ready? Take that breath. Let it out. Isn't it wonderful to be with loved ones and be together? I know Mike since we met in grade school on the football field. He was playing running back, and I was for the St. Jude's, and I was playing defensive back for Holy Family. He came around the end. I had him in my sights. I went to grab for his flag, and the only thing I remember is hitting the ground and turning around and seeing his back as he pranced into the end zone. The boy had some moves even back then. Last Sunday, we had a reading at Mass that I think exemplified Mike's life. It was from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. It read, "Brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks. For this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. I submit to you that that's how Mike lived his life. Rejoice always. Mike lived his life and exhibited joy to everyone he met. Always had a smile on his face and an encouraging word to say to you that made you feel better than about yourself than when you first ran into him. Even if you were giving him praise for one of his athletic accomplishments or for one of the many accomplishments of Kyle and Katie and Lindsay, Mike would somehow make you feel better about yourself after you had that conversation. In 2019, Mike received the Reverend Patty McGowan Award at Joliet Catholic for his athletic achievement and outstanding character. Dan Sharp, one of our classmates and the athletic director at Joliet Catholic, presented the award to Mike and introduced him in this way. If you have a strong work ethic and are willing to give effort, great effort, consistently, you'd be like Mike. If you showed love and respect for your parents and your brothers and sisters, bringing honor to your family name, you'd be like Mike. If you cared about your teammates and those around them more than yourself, you'd be like Mike. If you were able to form many friendships and inspire those friends to be better people, you'd be like Mike. If you show compassion for others and try to ease their pain, you'd be like Mike. If you're willing to meet any challenge with enthusiasm and fight through adversity, whether it came after a severe knee injury, after performing one of the greatest games in Hilltopper history, or battling a horrible disease with courage and grace, you'd be like Mike. We should all strive to be like Mike Condon. He has given us an example of how to live our lives. He set a standard that we should try to achieve as human beings and as children of God. Mike showed us that humility is a strength. Mike had an impact on all of us. Mike knew he was a beloved son of God and showed us how to live our lives as beloved children of God. Mike knew that there was more than this earthly life. He knew that there is eternal life. And through how he lived his life, was trying to help us share with him in eternal life. I think all of us would like to spend more time with Mike, right? Well, I know a way we can spend more time with Mike. In the beginning of my talk, I asked for some audience participation, and I'm going to ask for it again. In a moment, I'm going to ask you to take a deep breath. But this time, when you let that breath out, recommit yourself to Jesus Christ so you can be like Mike. So we can all rejoice once again, all together, with him and all of our loved ones in eternal life. Ready? Take that deep breath. Let it out, and let's all be like Mike, so we can see each other in eternal life. If you join me in prayer, and glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Michael. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Let us take a moment in silent prayer. Please stand. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Mike in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Mike in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As we conclude, ushers will dismiss everyone from their pews. Please keep a safe social distance while exiting the church.
God's smile.